you are required to design a cold storage for the given conditions. The given conditions are that storage capacity required is 500 tons of potatoes, and you are given two conditions, outdoor conditions and indoor conditions. So in the case of outdoor condition, you are given 35 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, 28 degrees Celsius wet bulb temperature, and for the indoor condition, that means the conditioned space, cold storage condition space, in that you require 20 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% RH. And weight content, water content of the potatoes is given as 76% by weight, and they are losing water as well, as given 0.01% per hour. And we have 25 persons working inside that space with a sensible heat load of 250 kilojoules per hour and latent heat load of 210 kilojoules per hour. This is per person. And fresh air is required to be supplied from outside. That means it is at the outdoor condition. So an equivalent amount of air from the conditioned space will be exhausted as well. And sensible heat gain through walls, ceiling, etc. is given as 17.4 kilowatts. And heat gain from equipments and respiration of potatoes is 3.5 kilowatts. And amount of infiltered air, so that is by the way of cracks of doors, windows, etc. So that infiltered air is amounting to be 200 meter cubes per hour, and this will also be at outdoor conditions as well. So these are the given conditions. Then what is required to be done? You are supplied with one more piece of information, that is, if the air conditioning is achieved first by cooling and dehumidification and then by heating. That means you are required to first cool and dehumidify the air, and then you are required to again heat it to the required temperature, whatever it is given. As we will be reading, then we will be finding it. Then you are required to find three things. First is amount of recirculated air. If recirculated air is mixed after fresh air before entering the cooling coil, that means the recirculated air will be mixed first with the fresh air, that is from the outside air, and then it will be sent to the cooling and dehumidification coil. And second part is capacity of cooling coil in TR and bypass factor if coil is at 5 degrees Celsius. So dew point temperature of coil is given 5 degrees Celsius, and capacity of heating coil, so which was our final element, in kilowatts. And the temperature of air entering the room is not to exceed 15 degrees Celsius. So how to attempt it? Attempting it, you see this figure. Is this figure visible to you? So is this visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, kindly yes, see in this particular diagram, this blue box, this is showing that this is the conditioned space. So our cold storage area is this part, and in this we are having a conditions 20 degrees Celsius DBT and 60% RH, and this is outside condition. Condition 1 is outside condition, 35 degree DBT, 28 WBT. Then whatever loads were given, I have indicated on this diagram, that sensible heating from wall, ceiling, glass 17.4 kilowatt, infiltered air at the rate of 200 meter cubes per hour, which is the infiltered air. And it will be at condition 1, that is why I have denoted it as M1. M1 is the mass flow rate. So mass flow rate is calculated here. I will show you that how it has been calculated from the psychrometric chart. Then 25 persons are working inside. Sensible heat load and latent heat load I have indicated. Sensible heat of potato plus equipment. Then 76% moisture is with this 500 ton of potato, and they are also losing moisture. So here you can see some vaporization has been shown at the rate of 0.01% moisture loss per hour. So this condition 2 air will be getting out from this duct. So I have indicated this duct here, and condition 2 air is going. Then as we know that we are required to input some fresh air from outside, here you can see VO, 4400 meter cube per hour is the volumetric flow rate of fresh air supplied from outside, it is given. So equivalent amount of conditioned space air will be exhausted from this particular point before mixing. And then in this T point, so here you can see this T point where this recirculated air and fresh air are mixing. So here you can see a light blue colored line meeting with a green colored line and then forming a blue colored line. So this light blue colored line is at conditions 2, cold storage conditions. This green colored line is at condition 1, outdoor conditions. And when they are mixed in line, they form another newer condition indicated with this blue color line, condition 3, which we will be seeing on the psychrometric chart. Then this air, mixed air, will be supplied to a CND coil, which is cooling and dehumidification coil with the surface temperature of 5 degrees Celsius as given to you. And after processing through this cooling and dehumidification coil, the conditions will change again to conditions 4, indicated by this orange color line. And finally, it will be processed through a heating coil. And final heated air will be not to exceed 15 degrees Celsius. So we are taking it as 15 degrees Celsius. And then conditions are again changing from condition 4 to condition 5, indicated with this purple colored line. So you are required to calculate the three things. So A part, mass of recirculated air, MR is equal to this question mark you can see here. Then B part is tons of refrigeration in this cooling and dehumidification coil. Bypass factor again for this cooling and dehumidification coil, and the final part was kilowatt of this heating coil, so capacity was required. So have you understood this part up till now, that what is given and what is asked?
Yes sir.
Is it clear to all?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
So it is any problem is there with understanding this, you can let me know. Then we'll going to this psychrometric chart. So here you can see this is a psychrometric chart. I've already explained to you that what are these axes. So total 7 psychrometric properties are there on the psychrometric chart. So depending on whatever is given, we will locate the points. So here we can see on the diagram of this cold storage, we are having 5 conditions. So there will be 5 points on the psychrometric chart. So starting with condition 1, so we are given, this is condition 1. So 35 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature. So here a vertical red line you can see, and 28 degrees Celsius wet bulb temperature. So this oranged color line, a dark orange colored line you can see, 28 WBT. So where to look for these temperatures is on their corresponding scales. So on the x-axis, this is dry bulb temperature scale, as you can see here. So here we are having 35 degrees Celsius, so dry bulb temperature 35 degrees Celsius, and wet bulb temperature, this is the scale on wet bulb or saturation temperature. Here you can see this 100% RH line. On this we are also having the same temperatures as given on the x-axis, the same temperatures are there. So they are vertically aligned. So from the wet bulb temperature 28, we are drawing a line. From dry bulb temperature 35, we are drawing a line, and wherever they meet, this is the conditions 1. So are you clear now how to locate this condition 1 on the psychrometric chart?
Yes sir.
Similarly for condition 2, this is how we will be locating it. So 20 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, this red colored line, and this dark orange color curve 60% RH. So here you can locate that these curves are relative humidity curves, and we are having values. So here you can see the values given. Here 30, 40, 50, and here behind this red colored line there was 60. So can you now locate this? So conditions 1 and conditions 2. So where these two are cutting, that is our conditions 2. So this is our target or final conditions required to be maintained inside the conditioned space. And condition 1 is the outside uncontrolled environmental conditions. Okay, up till this point it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then we can have bifurcation as well. So, what I am meaning here is that by drawing this right angled triangle by using these two points and the axis, so a line parallel to x-axis from point 2, and we are already having this line which was 35 degree dBt, and joining these two points, conditions 1 and 2, we are forming a right angled triangle, and we can read the enthalpies on this specific enthalpy at saturation scale. So here you can see the specific enthalpy at saturation for condition 1 H1, here it is 90 kilojoules per kg. For conditions 2, it is 43 kilojoules per kg, and at this intermediate imaginary point, which is not a condition at all in our diagram, but still we are locating this. I will be telling you why. And this is a small a condition, small a, and this is having enthalpy of 58.5 degrees Celsius. So, what for we have drawn this particular line is to have a look that when we are required to change these conditions 1 to conditions 2, overall we are having two different kinds of loads, that is sensible heat load and latent heat load. So, what is required? We are required to move in a direction from point 1 to point 2. In doing so, we can have a direct path by this light green colored line, or we can also have another path which is by following first this red colored line and then this dark green colored line. So this red colored line is at temperature T1 35 degrees Celsius, so no temperature change will occur if we are following this line or this path. So that means this is only a pure latent heat process, so either cooling or heating. This vertical axis is a pure latent process. So, the enthalpy difference between this H1 and HA, so 90 minus 58.5 is the latent heat load. And the remaining part, which is from point small a to point 2, this 58.5 minus 43, this is only a pure sensible heat load, because here we are not changing the moisture content. So on the y axis you are seeing that for both point 2 and both point A the moisture content is same, so the amount of water vapor per unit dry air remains constant, there is no evaporation or condensation process taking, so only a pure sensible heating or cooling process will occur along this dark green colored line. Is this clear up till now? Kindly respond in between.
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay. Now, coming on to the attempt. So, how do we plan to attempt this particular problem? So, here in this particular problem, you are seeing that we are following a series of processes. So, first of all, what we are doing is in this particular diagram, that conditions 2 are being withdrawn from the conditioned space, and then some part of it has been exhausted, and the similar part is then mixed in line. So here VO amount of air is taken from outside, and same not exactly this volume, but in the form of mass, the same mass of air will be exhausted. So, we are required to calculate the mass. Then what is happening? Inline mixing is occurring so that these conditions 3 are obtained. Then cooling and humidification process. After that, a heating process, and finally, we are getting this air back to the room. So, this is the process actually. So, here you can see in this particular diagram what is happening, that from condition 1, air is coming towards condition 2, from condition 2 air is coming towards condition 1. So why I have shown this? Because this air from condition 1, this is coming from the outside air. So here VO is equal to 4400 meter cube per hour. That part is indicated by this particular arrow. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, and sir. This arrow which is coming from conditions 2 towards condition 1 is the arrow, is that part of air which is recirculated.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And then finally they will meet somewhere in between on the line joining these two conditions, condition 1 and 2, and that condition will be somewhere around here. We are required to calculate it exactly, precisely, but for the time being, let us say that it would be somewhere around here, and then from there it is going to a cooling and dehumidification coil. So that cooling and dehumidification coil, this will be a process. If you see this particular diagram here, let me just bring out this pointer. Okay, so if you see this particular diagram here, so this is the direction in which you are required to go. So this is indicating cooling and dehumidification process. I have told you basic 8 psychrometric processes. In that process, in that particular class, I have told you that this is the direction of cooling and dehumidification process, which is third quadrant of the chart. So in that third quadrant direction, so wherever these two conditions are forcing the third condition to occur on this process line, from there an inclined line towards the left down arrow, left down side will be coming, and what would be the slope of this line will be indicated by this particular piece of information here. So here you were told that the surface temperature of coil is 5 degrees Celsius. That means the line which will be joining the condition 3 to 5 degrees Celsius at 100% RH line, because this 5 degrees Celsius was dew point temperature as given in the statement. So 5 degrees Celsius was dew point temperature, and when we say dew point temperature, it is on 100% RH line. So here you can see this is 90, so above that this will be 100%. So 80, 90 and then 100. So on the 100% RH line, this is 5 degrees Celsius. So a line joining from condition 2 to this point will be the process line for this cooling and humidification process. Okay. So as you have been already indicated that you are required to calculate the ton of refrigeration of this cooling and humidification coil, as well as bypass factor of this cooling and dehumidification coil. That itself means that the air will not reach 5 degrees Celsius temperature. It will be somewhere between the conditions 3 and 5 degrees Celsius. So it will be somewhere on this blue colored line, but not reach 5 degrees Celsius. So suppose that would be here, somewhere around here. And from that, this point you are also required to calculate, locate exactly. And from that, from there, a pure heating process is there. So here you can see this is the direction of pure heating process. So in the positive x-axis direction. So from there, we will be drawing a horizontal line. So this orange color line you can see, and this orange color line, that will be up till where? It will be up to the temperature 15 degrees Celsius. So from this unknown location, still yet to be known, up till this 15 degrees Celsius, this will be our conditions 5. And from there, we will be supplying this back to conditions 2. Okay? So is this clear?
Yes, sir.
So here this diagram is clear to you. So before solving for anything, I have explained to you that what would be happening one by one. So one after another, what are the processes that would be taking place?
Sir, can you please explain that point, why it won't reach 5 degrees Celsius?
It won't reach 5 degrees Celsius because, first thing, that not each and every molecule will be touching the cooling and dehumidification coil. So, some molecules will be bypassing that cooling and dehumidification coil. The molecules which will be touching the cooling and dehumidification coil might not reach instantaneously to the coil's temperature. If some molecules are reaching 5 degrees Celsius, or if we assume that each and every molecule which is touching the coil is reaching 5 degrees Celsius, then again after the coil has been passed, those two different temperature molecules will mix together and form some a temperature which is somewhere in between conditions 3 and 5 degrees Celsius. Okay, is this clear up till here?
Yes, sir.
Second point, which will be indicating that it will not reach 5 degrees Celsius, is that as in the numerical you have been asked to calculate bypass factor, that itself is indicating that some molecules are bypassing. It does not mean that each and every time if you are asked for some parameter, it will have a non-zero value. But for most of the time, it happens like this. If you have been asked to calculate something, that means it has some value. It might not be zero. It can still be zero. It can be in the exam that something which has been asked is a zero value. But don't confuse yourself with this point. It is not that important. But still it is indicating that there will be some bypass. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the process is clear to you that how will it occur on the psychrometric chart. Now,
yes, sir.
In this particular case, what you are required to do is, to attack onto this problem, we are required to answer three things. So, I have already mentioned this as this A part MR is equal to how much, B part TR, BPF and C part kilowatt. So, for calculating this, how should we proceed? For proceeding to calculate this, MR is mass of recirculated air. So, that is this particular part here. How much mass of air is coming from point 2 towards point 1 and meeting somewhere in between. This will be where our part A should be answered. So, that can be answered only if we know the precise location of this particular point, which is condition 3. Okay. So, how we will be knowing this particular point? That is required to be kept in our mind that somehow we are required to find out exact location of point 3, condition 3. Okay, we are not having that conditions right now. Let us proceed further so that we can have some more ideas how to proceed. If we look on to the part B, we are required to find out ton of refrigeration and bypass factor. So that means this blue colored line, this is of importance in the part B. So, in this particular line also, what we require for calculating ton of refrigeration and what we require for calculating bypass factor. For ton of refrigeration, you know it is basically the cooling capacity. So, cooling capacity of the coil, we can calculate the cooling capacity, which is nothing but the rate of heat transfer. We can calculate this Q is equal to M into delta H. In the refrigeration classes, in the numerical portion, you might have covered this formula that to calculate the heat transfer rate, Q is equal to M delta H. Same will be applicable here. In this case, M is the mass flow rate of air, delta H is the enthalpy change from initial to final conditions. So, ton of refrigeration will be this particular and this particular two conditions. So, condition 3 and condition 4 here. So, H3 minus H4 will be your delta H and m will be the overall total mass flow rate of air whatever is passing through cooling and dehumidification coil. So for calculating delta H, we need precise location of 0.4. So we need 0.3 and 0.4 both in the part 2, B part. So it cannot be done without attempting first part 1. Okay? Up till here, are you getting this? We have still not started at solving this. We are just discussing that what could be the possible way. Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
Now, yes, the sir. next part is indicating regarding the kilowatt of heating coil. So how much is the capacity of the heating coil here? You are required to calculate that. So here you can see kilowatt of heating coil. Same way, just like in the TR, it is the heat transfer rate, and this equation Q is equal to m delta H is still applicable here. So m is that particular mass flow rate which is passing through 0.4 to 0.5. So it is same as passing through 0.3 to 0.4. So it is same as passing from the cold storage to the air conditioning equipment. Okay, so m2 is equal to m5. Is equal to m. So this will be applicable in this part, and delta H is the H5 minus H4. So here will be H5, here will be H4. So this part 3 will not be attemptable until we know both 0.4 and 0.5. So we are required to locate all the 5 points. For this, 0.1 and 0.2 were already given. So is this clear? To attempt this numerical, to solve this, we need all of the intermediate conditions. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now coming on to how to know these, or how to solve for these remaining conditions. Now for that, this is the thing which you are required to do. So here, what you can see is that sensible heat factor is required to be calculated. In the theory classes, I told you that load calculations are required to be done. Load calculations means how much is the total amount of sensible heat and how much is the total amount of latent heat. You are required to calculate separately and calculate then after that a factor called as sensible heat factor, which can be calculated as sensible heat upon total heat. And how will it help? I will be telling you shortly. So here you see what are the sources of sensible heat in this particular problem. So this is sensible heat due to infiltration, which can be calculated as Q is equal to m delta H. So how much air has been infiltrated? This is the air infiltrated, m1, and this is how we are calculating m1. So m1, as you have already studied in your fluid mechanics class, Q is equal to mass into volumetric flow rate, or this density. So overall mass will be equal to this volumetric flow rate upon the density will give you mass flow rate. And we have been given mass, infiltrated air is 200 meter cubes per hour. If we divide it by the specific volume, so this is the specific volume. So here you can see on the chart, this is the specific volume scale. Here, are you getting this specific volume? Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
I have encircled that.
Yes.
So at this condition 1, we can see that this is around 0.903 meter cubes per kg value is for specific volume. So if we divide this 200 meter cube per hour by 0.903 meter cube per kg, we will get kg per hour. Is it so?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is how we will be converting this volumetric flow rate into mass flow rate, and to convert it back in the SI unit, because this kg per hour is not SI. So SI unit would be kg per second. So we have divided this value by 3600 to get 0.016 kg per second. So this is the mass of air infiltrated at conditions 1, and how much sensible heat load it is having. This is the part which is having sensible heat load, so which is HA minus H2. So I have told you this part was sensible heat and this part was latent heat. So this is where these two parts will be coming into picture. So this is Q is equal to M delta H. So in this case, M we have calculated like this, and delta H is HA minus H2 because sensible part only. Similarly, for infiltrated air, this is latent heat part. Same formula, M delta H, and in this case, delta H for delta H, this is H1 minus HA. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So sensible heat load for infiltration, infiltrated air, latent heat load for infiltrated air, then sensible heat load given for wall ceiling here, then sensible heat load for potato and equipment given here, sensible heat load for person. So we have 25% for each person, this was the load. So we have converted it into SI units. So this has been 25% into 250 kilojoules per hour. So for kilojoules it is into 1000, for per hour it is divided by 3600, and then we are getting this value. So by totaling these four terms, because these are only the four factors contributing to sensible heat load, we are getting total room sensible heat is 23.5897 kilowatts. Okay. Similarly, we are required to calculate total latent heat load. So for infiltrated air, I have already explained to you. For person, it is similar to this sensible only. The instead of 21250, it is 210 in this case. And for moisture loss, so here is the major part of latent heat load. Moisture loss. How to calculate this moisture loss? So for calculating this moisture loss, what you are required to do is, you are required to calculate in this particular fashion. As you already know, latent heat, the formula which you have studied in your lower standard classes, Q is equal to ML, is the formula for latent heat. So how much is M? M is the mass flow. What mass is flowing in this case? This is water vapor. So mass of water vapor flowing out of the product into latent heat. Latent heat is HFG. So what latent heat? It is latent heat of vaporization of water from liquid state to vapor state. And how do we calculate this? Is for mass flow, we are calculating in this particular fashion. This is the mass flow rate. So how much is the mass flow rate? Mass flow rate is mass of product into moisture content into moisture loss. So this is 500 into 1000 because it is ton, into moisture content it is 76%, then into moisture loss it is 0.01%, and then divided by time. What time? This is time per unit hour, per hour hai. So it is divided by 3600. Okay. And yes, then sir. Into HFG. HFG, the average value for latent heat of vaporization for water in the psychrometric problems is to be taken as 2500. So you must remember this point. It will not be given to you for your solving the numericals. You must remember this. Latent heat of vaporization for water for psychrometric numericals is to be taken as 2500. And what are the units? What would be the unit of this 2500? Anybody?
Kilojoule per kilogram.
Very good. Kilojoule per kilogram. Because it is enthalpy change, so same units. So all H are having same units. So it is kg, kilojoule per kg for every H term. Okay, so we are again totaling this latent heat load. So sensible heat load total, latent heat load total. So to calculate sensible heat factor, this is the equation which we would be using. Sensible heat factor is sensible heat upon sensible heat plus latent heat, or upon total heat. So we then calculating by using this equation, we found out the value as 0.442. So what to do with this particular term now? Anybody? What to do with this? Somebody can attempt respond.
Sir.
Yes.
जो imaginary point A है.
हाँ.
वो 0.1 और 2 को divide करता है SHF ratio में. SHF is to 1 minus HF.
तो उसका करना क्या है SHF का, पर ये तो बताओ. SHF कैलकुलेट कर लिया, हमारे से पूछा तो था नहीं. SHF कैलकुलेट करके बताओ. SHF इन दोनों को डिवाइड करता है, ठीक है बात, पर इस SHF का करें क्या अब? हाउ वुड दिस हेल्प इन सॉल्विंग दिस न्यूमेरिकल? ऑल थ्री पार्ट्स आर स्टिल रिमेनिंग. ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम्स, आई विल टेल यू दैट व्हाट दिस SHF इज शोइंग. सो हेयर यू कैन सी, दिस इज द SHF लाइन. सो 0.442 SHF वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड. सो हेयर ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्केल, हेयर यू कैन सी दिस इज सेंसिबल हीट फैक्टर स्केल रिटन हेयर. कैन यू सी दिस सेंसिबल हीट फैक्टर लिखा हुआ है, दिखाई दिया?
यस सर.
सो हेयर यू कैन सी ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्केल there are some lines drawn at varying angles. So at the value of 1, the angle is horizontal. As we are reducing this value, so here you can see at 0.4, this is the angle. At 4.5, this is the angle. So slowly, as the value of sensible heat factor is reducing, the angle is changing from horizontal towards vertical. So at the value of 0.442, so we are required to find out the value here on this scale. Suppose here we are getting some 0.442 value. So we are required to draw a line. So this line is sensible heat factor line with the value of 0.442. And what this is indicating is that if we supply the conditioned air from the air conditioning equipment to the conditioned space, so that particular air, that particular point after conditioning and the line joining that condition 5 and condition 2 is having this sensible heat factor, then our conditions 2 will be maintained. You must have not got the point. I will be again explaining this. That this particular sensible heat factor line is the slope of line joining this condition 5 and condition 2. Why? Because these all loads, sensible heat load and latent heat load, are the loads which are required to be nullified by the air conditioning equipment by suitably conditioning the air. So that means the air which we are required to supply to this cold storage should have this much less sensible heat and this much less latent heat, so that when we add that air back to the cold storage by adding these two heat loads, overall conditions 2 will not change, because we are required to maintain conditions 2 at the state condition 2 only. Because in the conditioned space, in the conditions 2 air, in this space, we are having this load, this load, this particular load, this load and this load. So whatever air is coming from this point should have these loads less, so that by adding these all loads, the conditions are not changing. Are you getting this now?
Yes, sir.
So the air which is required to enter the air conditioned space should have this much less sensible heat and this much less latent heat. So it will be having these less sensible and latent heats if it is along this slope of line. So we are required to draw a line parallel to this sensible heat factor line from point 2. Okay, so we are required to draw a line parallel to this sensible heat factor line from point 2. And then that line, when it is cutting this 15 degree Celsius line, we have found out 0.5. Okay? Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
So, we will be attempting this numerical in this particular fashion because we are still far away from finding 0.3. So, if we can find it from the reverse direction, then we should attempt in that direction. After that, if we are again, if it is possible to find 0.3 or 4, whatever is possible first, we will find that first. Okay, so by finding 0.5, can we attempt this part C? For part C, we require 0.4 also. So we cannot yet attempt part C. So that means we are required to find out 0.4. To attempt part C, we are required to find 0.3. To attempt part 1, we are required to find this 0.4 to attempt part C. And for part B, 3 and 4 both are required. So by calculating the sensible heat factor, it has led to find out 0.5. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
So this is 0.5. Are you getting now 0.5? As soon as we have located 0.5, we have immediately found out H5. Okay? So as soon as we have located any point on the psychrometric chart, all of the 7 properties, psychrometric properties, will be known. Okay? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, what to do next? In this case, in this particular case, as we are knowing now that we are required to find whatever we can find first, we are then proceeding in that direction. So here in the VO case, we were given that volumetric flow rate which has been supplied from outside by using because this is at conditions 1. So by using same V1, we are finding out MO. So mass from air from outside, we have found out. Okay. And for M5, we can use this particular equation. So what is this equation? This equation is basically, Q is equal to M delta H. So, how we are applying this equation in this particular form is that M is equal to Q by delta H. M is equal to Q by delta H. Can we apply this? By using this equation, Q is equal to M delta H, M will be equal to Q upon delta H. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So, this is M5 and this is Q. Q is total heat load. And this is delta H, which is H2 minus H5. This is delta H. Because we have found out room sensible heat, room latent heat, added together, this is total Q, total heat load. So M5 is equal to room sensible heat plus room latent heat divided by H2 minus H5, which gives us m5 is equal to 6.135 kg per second. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Getting this? Now, from this particular T junction, what we can see is, from this side MO is coming, from this side MR is coming, and here M3 will be going out. So that means M3 is equals to MO plus MR. Okay? From this particular junction, can you see this equation? Logical enough?
Yes, sir.
But you can see that M3 is equal to M4, is equal to M5, is equal to M2. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So that means M5 is equal to MO plus MR. So this equation we have used here. So MR is equal to M5 minus MO. MO we have calculated here. M5 we have calculated here. So here we get MR, question 1 attempted. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Everybody is getting this, because this kind of numerical view are required to attempt in the examination, and these type of numericals will definitely come without any choice. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Then going on further, to find out the point 3, so here you can see, in this case we are having mixing of two air streams. So from point 2 this side, from point 1 this side, two air streams are coming, meeting together and meeting at point 3 here. How to find out this? By using this mixing of air stream formula. So in this case, how can we find out this point 3 is that the value of enthalpy H3 will be a weighted average of value of enthalpy H1 and value of enthalpy coming from H2. So H3 here will be equal to M1 H1 plus M2 H2 divided by M3, because M1 H1 plus M2 H2 will be equal to M3 H3. If we put this M3 here, so what this forms is M1 H1 plus M2 H2 equal to M3 H3. So this will be an enthalpy balance equation. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
But here, what is coming from point 1, conditions 1, is MO, not M1. MOH1. And from conditions 2, this is MR, not M2. So from conditions 2, this is MR coming. From conditions 1, this is MO coming. So this equation will be required to be modified in this case, this way. And here we know value of all these parameters. MO we have calculated, here it is, H1 on the graph, MR previously calculated in the last step, H2 on the graph, M5 just calculated previous to this step. So finding out H3, so as soon as you found out H3, drop a line for parallel to this enthalpy scale on this chart, we can locate then point H3. Is it okay? So this is how point H3 will be located. Are you getting this? So up till here, point 1, 2, 3, 5 will be located. Point 4 is still missing. So as the point 4 is missing, we cannot answer part B or part C, because for both part B and part C, point 4 is required. Okay? So point 3 has come. What to do next? This is the last step. And how do we calculate this is? From point 3, I have already told you, we are required to draw a line which is joining this 5 degree Celsius here. And then as we had already known the value of 0.5, we have to draw a horizontal line in this backward direction. And wherever these two cross, this will be 0.4. This is a purely graphical location of point 4. No calculations. So drawing a line from point 3 joining this point 5 degree Celsius on 100% RH line and drawing a horizontal line from point 5 in this negative x-axis direction wherever they meet, this is point 4. As soon as point 4 is located, H4 will be clear. And as the point 4 has now come, both these two parts, part B and part C, are not a problem. So here you can see capacity of cooling coil, same formula, Q is equal to M delta H. So M is M5 because from the cooling coil M3 is coming, M3 is equal to 4 is equal to 5 is equal to 2. So M5 is the same. And what is the conditions before and after? This is 4 and 3. So H3 minus H4 is delta H. So this is kilowatts. To convert kilowatt into TR, divide by 3.517. So this is TR. And for the bypass factor, using this particular equation, this is bypass factor. So how did we calculate bypass factor in our theory classes? So this was the amount bypassing and this was the amount not bypassing. So bypass factor is this amount divided by total. So this amount is this much. So it is T4 minus TS and total is from here T3 minus TS. So this is bypass factor. And finally for the last part, capacity of heating coil, again Q is equal to M delta H. So in this case delta H is H5 minus H4 and this is how much it is coming.